What is heat transfer and how does it work? Let's talk about it. Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to be discussing three main types of heat transfer and how your house can be protected from it. Before we go down this path, please go below, hit that like button for us. It really helps us out. So if we're going to talk about this, I have to really take us back a little bit. Back before I was the professor of foam, I have to take you all the way back to my 8th grade earth science class when Mr. Finch taught me about conduction, convection, and radiation and how heat transfer works. So if we think about this, these are lessons that we've learned a long time ago, but we've probably never thought about how it relates to our home. So let's break each of these things down. First, heat transfer by conduction. Simply put, this is heat transfer through physical contact. You can think about cooking in a pan. So you put a pan down on the stove, that pan gets hot. You put some food inside that pan, the heat transfers through the pan into the food, heats it up, and cooks it. Again, physical contact. You could think about your house, same thing. Anytime a heat source can physically heat up a surface, like drywall, and transfer through and out of your house, heat loss through conduction. Now let's talk about convection. Simply put, heat loss through air movement. So if you think about your forced air furnace, like most of us have in our homes, you're heating up air and forcing it with some type of fan through those vents into your house to warm up all the rooms in your home. So that heat is being carried through air. Now, as you can imagine, it's a really effective and quick way to heat up a home. Heat travels very quickly through air movement. So again, heat loss or heat transfer through convection. Next thing we're going to talk about is radiation. So you can easily think about this as it's simply heat waves, right? So if we think about the sun, sitting out in the sun, you can feel it's really warm compared to standing in the shade. When it comes to your house, think about a wood stove. Right? So if you put wood in a wood stove, get this stove really warm. If you sit or stand right next to the stove, it's really hot because those radiant waves are coming off real strong right next to that heat source. So again, radiant waves, you can feel something coming off of a strong heat source. Simply how wood stoves work. So you always want to make sure you're addressing all three of these when you're looking at using a building material. So if you're looking for an insulation, you always want to make sure you use something that combats conduction, convection, and radiation. Just like foam insulation, by being a good thermal resistant material, providing that air seal, which is crucial when you're talking about attics, walls, anything that has a lot of penetrations inside or outside of the house. Radiation, when it comes to your house, kind of gets handled on the outside. But again, if you have things inside your home that generate heat, and you all do, even our bodies generate heat, you want a strong material like foam that will keep that heat in. So again, make sure you're battling all three of these things when you're looking at an insulation material, just like foam insulation does. So to learn more about heat transfer, please check out the link below. Also, don't forget, like this video, subscribe to our channel, and ring that bell so you see all of our notifications.